We are talking to Blue Chip Ryan Martin, one of the most talented fighters in the world. I've seen you fighting Canelo's undercard in the past, the Dallas Cowboys Stadium. You stole the show. You're fighting again, and this time Canelo Triple G. You've been in camp with Triple G in the past. Tell me about training alongside Triple G, and what do you think about his fight with Canelo?
Man, training with him, it's an awesome experience because, even though he's the pound-for-pound best fighter, he pushes himself. He wants you to be better. Fighting on this card means a lot. Biggest fight is going to be in a long time. And, I think it's going to be amazing for the Main Street fam and everybody in the world just to get this fight and see these two warriors go at it. It's going to be an amazing night.
Can you pick a winner, a prediction?
Yeah, I got...
Oh, the fans are the winners. That's what I say when
the
I
fans are the... Yeah, you're right. The fans are the winners, but... I got Triple G late stop.
Obviously, he's 20 pounds bigger than you. Have you ever sparred him? Or?
No.
No, I don't know. Sometimes
if I had an opportunity, I would. Because like I said, I've been in there with Triple G.
But have you seen him spar much bigger guys, like light heavyweights and heavyweights? Yes. What does he do? What does Triple G do when he spars heavyweights?
He hurts him. He pulls him down. He knocks him out. The man is like, he is like a fucking truck. Like he's
a Mack truck. Yeah. And he takes him.
And
he's 160.
He's 160. It's a bag in the house. And when he hits the bag, the whole house shakes.
Wow.
So I'm like, man, this guy, like, so much power.
Check it out. James Toney and Roy Jones Jr. both won championships from 160 to heavyweight, and we always said we'll never see anyone do it. Do you think Triple G could be that one guy that does it if he's knocking him out? Obviously, it has to be the right heavyweight, but can he do
If it's the right heavyweight, yes, I believe.
Like, John Ruiz was the right one for Roy Jones Jr., so you move up for the right fight.
Actually, so when you made that's a good point. I think he could do it if the right people is in front of him as to go up in weight.
That would be insane,
He has tremendous power. You know, he's a smart fighter. He has a good coach, too. So.
You have something in common with Triple G. Both of you guys are so mellow outside of the ring. Very low-key. Invisible. If you walked here and they didn't say Ryan Martin sitting here, I wouldn't notice. But he's the same way. Very unassuming.
Yeah.
But you guys turn it on in the ring. What time do you turn on? Is that when the gloves are wrapped? When the hands are wrapped?
No. As soon as you walk in that venue, that's when you got to turn that switch on and know you're there for business. You know, you're there for a very serious reason. You know, this is your life. This is nothing else matters besides... Nothing else matters at all but that fight, that night. So everything else you can put aside, you just gotta get through that night.
Now, Ryan, you had a crazy experience in your career. The different promoters, different managers. There was a point you and 50 Cent were best friends. No, I mean, what's he like as a person? Forget the business.
Oh, thanks. Man, as a person, he's an amazing person, very smart.
Inspirational?
Very business-minded, you know, street smart. And I never have anything bad to say about him. He gave me a lot of wisdom, a lot of advice.
Live exposure.
that I still stick with through today, and great man.
Okay, which song are you walking out to your next fight?
I have no idea right now. You know,
tell him which song to walk out to.
What's up?
Black Beatles, like Broner. Who?
Amigos, what the price is.
What the price is, Amigos.
How does it go? How does it go?
I don't even know the song.
How does it go? Give me a verse.
Nah, it's not. It's not PG-13.
It's okay. Dude, we're X-rated.
I'll tell you what though. We can have Rick Ross. You watch this. You come to Vegas. We want you to walk out with Meek Mill.
You want me to tag him? I'm gonna tag him.
We're
gonna watch it. Meek Mill or Rick Ross? Which one?
Both. I mean, either one. It don't even matter.
Where are you from originally?
I'm from Chattanooga, Tennessee.
You have 8-Ball and MJG from Tennessee.
Yeah.
That's Memphis.
But they haven't been. They haven't had a song out in 10 years.
Yeah.
Let me ask Joey. Which rapper should walk him out for his next fight? If you could pick one rap superstar right now.
One rap superstar, right?
Who do you listen to?
Mark Too Short.
Mark Too Short.
Watching this, be in Vegas.
Remember
next
Mark
weekend.
Davis?
Yeah. Is he a rapper now?
He's a rapper now.
Wow. He can fight.
He's legitimately a rapper now.
Yeah.
Can you flow?
Can I flow? Absolutely not. I'm a dancer. I'm not a rapper.
Okay.
I can't flow either.
You're a 140 fighter. You and McGregor in a boxing match. How long does it last?
Two rounds.
Two rounds? You put him to sleep?
Yeah.
Put him to sleep?
Dead asleep.
Dead asleep.
Snoring.
Sleep.
One hand tied behind your back?
No, I need both my hands.
Okay. I didn't ask you about this one, but if Anthony Joshua fights Wilder, everybody here, always they pick Joshua. I got Wilder. What do you think?
I'm a big Wilder fan. I personal relationship with him, but that'd be a good fucking fight. Good fight. Damn.
Okay, 140 division.
I asked my manager that question.
Who you like in that one, Tim?
Anthony Joshua.
I like Wilder.
All right, why?
Because 37 knockouts in 38 fights, and if you saw the Klitschko Joshua fight in round 5 or round 6 when Joshua was out, Klitschko didn't pulled the trigger and backed off. If that's Wilder, he takes him out.
Okay.
Well, I told him yesterday.
He likes his heavyweight, the Ukraine, the, what's his name? The UFC guy, what's his name?
Stipe Miocic.
He likes him against anybody.
Stipe. He wants him with anyone.
Any heavyweight.
Boxer.
Listen, we're just coming off the weakest heavyweight division in the history of boxing. The Klitschko's dominated because there was no one to fight. Right or wrong?
They're promoters right here, man.
I mean, he's retired now.
He's done.
Okay.
Right.
I love his promoter.
Yeah.
But the division itself, who was the next best heavyweight during that 10-year period?
That's true.
Quick, tell me. Who was it?
Deontay Wilder.
No, that 10-year period, he's...
No, you're right. It was a very weak division. That's true. It wasn't. It lost its luster, as they say.
Listen, I know I said I couldn't flow, but I wrote a rap once.
Okay, let's go.
And here it is.
Okay.
This is the old
Joey
school
Delgat.
Rap. Okay, and this is true.
Okay.
At any weight, we dominate. Our hard work will seal their fate. We won't stop until we all are great. We do the work that others won't to win the wars that others don't. We work on a level they can't believe to achieve goals they can't conceive. In each other, we do believe. Rumble, young man, rumble. Teeny time. Baby.
Bars, baby.
Saturday night. Teeny time.
Hey, you and
rumble,
Floyd Sr.
young man, rumble.
You and Floyd Sr. What's that, rap battle on MTV? They have a show.
Rap battle? The man can't even talk.
No, he can. Floyd Sr., he got speed, too. Floyd, he could do it.
The last rap that he did.
Nick Cannon wilding out. You can put him over.
Yeah, wilding out. Oh, that was pretty good. You wrote it yourself?
I wrote it. Did I write it?
No, did you copy it? It's not plagiarized anymore.
No, absolutely not.
Mark Too Sharp Davis wrote him that rap.
Oh, that's bad.
He did not write that rap. He did not
okay.
write that rap.
Tell everyone where to follow you.
You follow me at Joe Delguide Old School Boxing Club on Twitter, Joe Delguide Old School Boxing Club on Instagram, and Joe Delguide on Facebook.
Okay, who is a better rapper, Floyd Sr. or Joey Delgado?
I didn't get to hear Joey.
Oh, no,
you didn't get to hear me, Flo?
I just walked in.
I didn't get to see Floyd Sr.
Floyd Sr.? Yeah. He got a million of them. He even sings right now. He was singing for me a song for Conor McGregor, like a pallbearer song, like when you lay someone to rest.
He had a nice jab, though. Did you see when he was like,
it's not here, it's gonna be a
showing everybody what his jab was still like?
Yeah, he got it.
We'll have to meet you there.
Ryan Martin fighting on the Triple G Canelo fight. Do you know who you're fighting? We forgot to ask.
I'm fighting Francisco Rojo out of Mexico.
Yeah, this way you're just with us.
What's your record right now?
19-0.
That's crazy.
11 knockouts.
That's pretty good. Keep it going.
Should have 18 knockouts.
Make sure y'all tune in.
Oh, this is what I was going to say. You fight at the 140 division.
135.
Sorry. Packed division. A lot of champions. You have Robert Easter Jr. You have Mikey Garcia has a belt. Who would you want to fight? You have Linares. And what happened in that fight?
I knock him out.
Linares gets old in one night, and Ryan Martin becomes a WBC lightweight champion of the world.
What, in the WBA.
Do you agree?
Absolutely.
Yeah. Ryan's going to stop your ass, Linares. We're coming for you.
All right, there you have it. Anything to tell Linares?
Man, just, I'll be at the fight the following weekend after Miami until you do your thing, and we meet up later next year.
All right, if Quadras brought a chicken, what would you bring for Linares?
I have Quadras bring the chicken.
All right, stay tuned right here, Ryan Martin. Look out for
Blue Chip. Keep that boy awake.
FeasterDreamPoint.com and Ballistic Bike reporting. Yeah.